Yeah, so here at the Fixer Upper House, we put up our trampoline that we've had for a few years in storage. My son did a good job putting this together. But we need to get it tied down so it doesn't blow away. Our neighbor said the old owners of this had one blow away and mess up their fence. So question is, how do we get this tied down? So what we're gonna try, since in the hill country here, everything is just a bunch of rocks, is we're gonna try to tie it down with these conduit clamps here. And I have my SDS Plus, 1-inch SDS Plus drill. I'm gonna try that. It's supposed to go up to, of course, 1 inch. And we have a 1/2-inch bit here. And I didn't bring the anchors, but I have anchors, which I'll show you, that shows that we will try to put in the rock, and then use the awl thread here to tie down the conduit straps, and then a couple nuts. So let's see if this works.
Go.
Okay, so get this unhitched here. See what we can get this off with. Stop it. So if you've not used an SDS Plus drill, this is new for us. We have a drill area, a hammer area, and a area for a chisel, which we'll do some, hopefully sometime later indoors. But SDS, I think, is German for something like push in, twist, and lock. And that's all you need to do is twist it in there and it's ready to go. Okay, so this strap is a bit oversized here, but should work. And so we want to find a nice clean spot here and get that started. Let's see how it goes. I just have the hammer on, so let's get the hammer and the drill. That will help. Okay, here we go. Let's see how she goes now. Whoops, so you need to have a good tight grip on the thing. And this should allow me to turn this sideways. Yeah, so this has an ingenious depth gauge, which we probably should use, but it's not so important for our task. And so we need to rotate this for the job we're doing now. And get that tied in there. Let's see how she goes. Now I'm using our 12 amp hour battery. Probably good enough to get an 8 or 9, but this is what we have. So. Yeah, that's going well. Now we'll get our anchor and see how that goes. Okay, we're back in our shop area here, our storage area, and we need to get the anchors. Here, the anchors that I have, I got this on the first house we owned, oh, more than 20 years ago, 25 or so. And as you saw, it was a 1/2-inch outside diameter. And this has a pin in here, which you pound down with this tool, and it splays this back end out. And then we have a threaded portion, which is 3/8. So this is how we're going to get it done. Okay, so we've got our anchors. Now we're going to see if we drilled deep enough. So let's see how we're doing here. Get our awl thread. I wanted to use stainless awl thread. I like using stainless whenever I can, but this doesn't. Home Depot didn't have it at the time, so. And or the home center. So let's see if this goes in the whole way. It's in, and that's good. And that should be good enough. So let's try that. Okay, so we've got this. And we've got our hand sledge here. I don't know, probably is a modern name for this little guy, but that's what we called it back in the hills of Pennsylvania. So, pounding this will knock that wedge back, and that should keep it secured in there. Let's see, now let's give a little more. Probably better to hold it, huh? In fact, I bent it. See, isn't that too bad? Okay, so see if this gets in here. Looks like it's holding down okay. And got this. Yep. So I need to put this in and then screw it down and cap it off, and then we'll cut it. Stop it. Okay, so I'm afraid we here at Greeenhorn Acres we've got tools we've had for a long time. So we're gonna go corded with our Sawzall. And of course the term for this is reciprocating saw. Here's my old one. So we're gonna use that to cut this off. And I don't want to cut it off low because I might have trouble working with it. So what we're going to do is use these rebar caps that you can get at your home center, and we'll put the awl thread high enough to cap it. Then it'll be easy to see and easy to deal with. So that's what we're going to do now. Now, how we're going to try to get this down, the way you try to deal with these is so you use two nuts instead of one, and they can lock together. Okay, so we're rolling up our two bolts here. Put that in. And put this in here. You know, I think I I need two of these to get this tight, but let's see what happens here. That's just gonna move the one below. So I'll need, oh, no, it's starting to turn it, so that's good. I probably should have had two to tight them against each other. I'm gonna have to do that for the final tie down. But this is putting it in, so that's good. Well, so some of you might have the same problem with my Greenhorn son here, how to unroll these guys. Well, you wanna unroll from the outside in and take advantage of this handle here. So, fortunately, he think got things started a little bit early. So we'll get this, see if we can tie that back down. Okay, great. So we got this tied back in, and we'll use the handle here. This is where we're gonna plug in, and we'll run this up to the house. So with the Sawzall, of course, you have many different kind of blades. You have the wood blades and the metal blades, which are finer. So of course, we're going to use a metal blade for this application. Okay, so we're going to get this down here, tighten this in. Now, when you have awl thread, you're going to cut it, right? It will tend to ruin the threads, right? So how can we take care of that? Well, you can use chaser nuts. I think I have a set around here, but often you can just use the nut itself. So this is another reason for that second nut there. So we're gonna get that down out of the way. And here's our little cap that we're gonna stick on here. And so we're gonna cut it up at that height. Here's our Sawzall. And we'll use our key to get the final tightness on the thing. Okay, well, of course, for the corded power tools, you have to plug in the cable. So we got that. Now let's cut this, get it up close to the edge there, and let's cut it. Okay, that's cut off. And just make sure the threads are good, and they're not bad at all, actually. That's nice. Okay, so we'll tighten this down. So again, the second one kind of locks that other one in. Now, of course, if you don't live in a Texas hill country, you won't have rocks to screw into, and you'll have to try another method to pull it down. I'd show that, but this is where we are today. So that's down there, and I don't think this will go anywhere. We have one of our anchors in. Now there's, I think, six legs on this trampoline, and so we'll do every other leg. So the three other legs over here, and the one over here. Okay, so I said everything's all rock, but we have to get down to the rock if we're going to get this done. This is a spade for digging trenches. I don't think it's going to be that useful here in the hill country. Get down to the rocks here. Okay, so doing this area here. So this is one spot. And this here. That's right about there. Okay, so try, it's not quite deep enough, so let's get a little more in there. Okay, so drop that in and get this one pounded in. So this other side was done well, but this one might need some help, so let's try getting this on here. Yep, they'll go on fine. Okay, so I'm gonna get this in. I'll use the two nuts again. Okay, now we've got the Sawzall. Let's get this cut. You need to put it down some. Okay, so this was a little too loose. So we used as an old trick, using a hand sledge, something heavy, to push against it while cutting that off. And so that's something always to remember. If something's too wobbly to cut against, and put pressure on the other side. Okay, let's see if the threads are good here. And they are. So now we can use this bottom nut to get this up at the level we want and then tighten them against each other. Okay, so we've got the bottom nut here where we want it. That's placed right. And we're gonna tie down the top nut now. And that should hold her down. Last step, pop that on. Okay. Got that done on the third one.
So right here?
No, you need to get the bracket.
I thought there was only two brackets. No, there's three. So around there.
Okay.
A little hole now.
No, that won't work. You just have to eyeball where it is.
An indent.
There you go. Uh-huh.
Right here.
You have to use two hands, son, and don't let it roll off. You're already way off of where you started.
Right here?
Uh-huh. Hold on. You don't have it on hammer. You have to push in the red thing. Yeah, that's a hammer drill now. Okay, make sure you got the position right. There you go. Okay, you have the anchor. No, that's not an anchor, that's a bracket. Get the anchor. Try not to step, let's not step on the bolts and lose them. Get the anchor. Okay, now don't pound it in yet. Is it, no, you have to put it in with an awl thread so you can pull it back out again.
Well, there's a first step that I didn't do.
Here, get the grass out of there so it's easier to see. Pull the grass out.
Actually did some grass work with Bob, with Grandpa.
You need two hands, son. We're gonna rip your arm off. Put those down. Okay, now get your awl thread on the anchor.
Anchor.
You can test if it's deep enough then. So he's got the anchor in. Now is it below the surface? No, you have to go another 3/8, about a half inch. Make sure you got two hands on it or you're going to rip your arm off. There you go. That's it. Clean it out.
Stone's hot.
Try it again. Clean it out. Okay. I think you still have some
stuff in there.
Dirt in there, so clean it out again. Pull up slowly. There you go. Now try not to knock any stuff in. Hold it still. Yeah, it's down below the surface, so that's good. Okay, so now you've got that right. So now we want to use the that pin. Make sure you hold on to it. The last time we hold on to it with one hand so it doesn't bend. And just pound, 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 pound. Keep pounding. Okay. Okay, and so yes, the threads are good on the that we cut here. That's good. So we're gonna thread that in, but we have to get the nuts on. Okay, so now he's putting the threads on, the nuts on. Okay. Now get two of those together and tighten the nuts against each other. You need both of them. Tighten one against the other.
I'm just trying to get one to
okay.
do the exact measurement.
Okay. Actually, you don't do it with those types of adjustables. You just tighten it with your thumb when it's time to turn it. You have to tighten them against each other. One goes one direction and one goes the other.
That's easy to do.
Here, let me show you. Okay, so when you're tightening with two wrenches, you want this always to go in the motion of that you're trying to turn. So we're trying to turn this way. That means this one goes this way, and this one goes this way. So that's great. Unfortunately, you have it at the wrong end, so we'll fix it. That. Okay, so now we'll get on the end. So what we're doing is we're always cutting off of the same end. Always leave that factory edge we might need at some point. So we'll get this so it's deep enough, so it's easy to get to, and then we'll tighten it again, right? So. Always put them in the direction of motion. Yeah, that's right. So use the more clumsy, bigger one for an anchor on your not your main hand, and then use the one that you on your main arm. Yeah, that's good enough. You don't have to be anything special. Just has to be tight enough to get the awl thread in there. Okay, so flip it over. Okay, so flip it over here and we'll get this. Okay, use the top nut. Put her in. You're going the wrong way. No, don't loosen it. No.
Move the dirt's in the way.
It's not in the way. Okay, let me go.
Well, dirt is in the way.
There's nothing wrong with the dirt.
The dirt was in the way.
We'll tighten it down here. Two nuts are going against each other, locks that in, and we can turn down the awl thread. That should be tight enough. Now again, we'll adjust these two to the height, top one to bottom one to the height that we want, and then tighten down the top one. Loosen the top one. So why do you want to loosen the top one? What we're trying to do is adjust the height of the bottom one, and we can't adjust the height until we've gotten the top one up out of the way. In fact, you're gonna have to unscrew it, so don't do that yet. Hold on, stop, put her back down. Okay, and so we're gonna get the cap, cut the top off again like we did the other two. We're gonna cut this, so we're gonna do it right about to here. Okay, so get your Sawzall out. Okay, give me the hand sledge. Whoops.
I have no experience in this saw. Any damage I do would.
Okay, and I'll show you. Okay, you want to be as tight as you can to the awl thread with your Sawzall. All the way against the, put this all the way against and keep it tight, okay? Now go ahead and start it, rock back and forth. No, tight against, I said, tight against. Stay tight against. Rock it back and forth. Rock back and forth. No. Don't pull back. Rock back and forth. Rock.
Rockabye baby. Okay, so there you go. Okay, that's it. That's it. Okay, so now we can get this top one off. Go ahead. Get the top one off. That's it. Hmm. Yeah, top one off. Yeah, now adjust the height of the bracket. How about bending it sideways? Can you bend it? Hold on. So you need to go down with that nut. Down with the nut. Down. Yeah. That's it. Keep going. That's keep. You want to get that all the way on the surface, so keep going down. It's not. Keep going down.
It's touching.
Well, that's good enough. Okay, so let's put the other top on. Probably would have gone down further, but all we're trying to do is to keep this from flying away in a storm. And this should definitely do it. So he's still working on that. So we got our main, our first one over there, and then our second one. And so, as I said, most of you won't be in a place that you can put things in with the rocks, but I'm sure that you can learn some things at this. Now, what we do, no, don't pound with that. Just use your hand. Did you tighten it?
Yeah.
You didn't only tighten it with your hand, so tighten the bolt, the nut. But there we are. So that's a project to keep the trampoline down. Now, you, son, had some pointers about putting the trampoline together. Now, this is our second trampoline that we've purchased, and we really like this design. The first design had this all sort of woven together with, like almost a shoelace material, and it took forever, and it was very hard to get apart. This one was very easy to assemble and disassemble. Now, there's a tool to get these off, and of course, since we've had everything in storage and whatnot, we lost the tool. So show them how you do these off here. So the first one.
With your hand.
Uh-huh.
Latch it over.
Yeah.
Take the big hook of the hooks in here. Pull. And that's it.
There you go. Okay.
And you also do vice versa.
Yeah, to put them back on again. Okay, and we'll try to have a link to this this brand. We really like this brand of trampoline. Okay, so let's go the other way with this tool. So you have two sides, of course, right? The male plug and the female plug. And so which side do you want to put in these tools? You want to start with the female side, and that way it won't rub against you as you're winding it up. And also, you can just unwind the one side and leave this wound up, so you don't have to unwind the entire tool. You leave that there at your job surface and then just plug it in. And so that's useful as well. So put that here. And that there. And then you can wind her up. Okay, and of course I mentioned we had a good thunderstorm today. Not a windstorm, so we won't have this tested yet, but as you can see, it's still held down there. You see the three re-rod caps there. I think they look pretty good, and this is a project that seems to have gone well.